Alright, since I have enough time to do another one, I will. Okay, so back to the midway point of the level I just completed and found the secret exit too. Now, this pipe leads me here. So now, of course, I get curious to see if any more pipes are any use. Now I'm not stuck there, obviously, but I was still curious about the pipe, so I tried it. And lo and behold, it worked! Another mutant duck, and I find a piece of it. I try to go back up the pipe with it, but for some reason or another, that's just a reset pipe. So, with that in mind, I totally step on that spiny there. And I don't seem to have made any real progress with that P-switch. So, go figure. Moving along, I spin jump on top of a piranha plant, which, given that they're not spiky on top, I should totally just be able to stomp on them anyway. Oh, and for the record, this will be the last of these videos that I do without live voice recording. That's right, next time I'll try to figure out a way to actually put my voice into the video while I'm recording it, rather than doing it this silly way. That kind of makes it sound like I'm rambling on. And is far less entertaining, I'm sure. So, normal exit leads me to another level. And for some reason, the music has cut out for this for the overworld here. I'm not sure why. Anyway, Starland Slime! Now, I actually do recognize these water tiles from having been from Super Mario Land, since I borrowed it from a friend once. Long, long time ago. But regardless, this was a thorn for me for a while, and you will see why. Anyway, moving along, this actually is a really good-looking level here. An interesting idea, although it is really strange that the fire enemies are just able to normally wade their way through this floating water. Which, come to think of it, the only time this kind of water was used in Super Mario Land was inside trees. In some sort of small land where you were jumping on top of ants and the like. So, or was it some other land? Either way, I know that it probably wasn't water, but rather some form of tree sap. Anyway. So I continue to be befuddled by these fire enemies, as you can see. Because I kind of forgot at the time that they chase you. My goodness, will those spinies ever fall? They do take a long time to actually get somewhere when they're stuck in water. If only because water kind of reduces any amount of falling speed on enemies by like a third. Or to a third, I should say. Okay, so obviously this pipe is really hard for me to get to. Mainly my fault at the time, because I was trying to carry a shell in. But I really have no idea what I was doing here. So I tried that pipe and nothing. Then checkpoint and fire flower. Or whatever the heck that object is. Anyway, it looks like I'm going for the normal exit. I haven't watched this video ahead of time. So it kind of sounds like I'm going through it for the first time. This is actually a really good idea. Having floating water all over the place to make, you know... It's almost like having platforms wherever you want in the less logical sense, I guess. I don't know. It's a cool idea. I'll leave it at that. Just wades head first in the water without any second thoughts. Although you totally know that his big ol' schnoz would be filled to the brim with water. Let's not discuss that topic, and I go back inside to try to figure out where that stupid key was. Because we all saw that keyhole down there, right? Moving along. At speeds that would totally not do anything to an egg. Mutant ducks have infested the pond! Luigi, stop them! Luigi, where are you going? Take care of them! Now, Luigi, you don't care about the environment, do you? Just keep smashing your head into the ceiling until you figure out what you're supposed to be doing. I apologize for that. I kind of bored myself watching me go back through the stage a second time. Getting killed by that same fireball that was a thorn in my side the first time I went through it. I don't know why I didn't just skip through and why I still hadn't changed my rewind button to something other than the control key, which spazzes out my video. Good lord, it's like molasses! And then I failed the jump, but that was totally my fault. Stomp on some old men and make their balls wingless. More attempts at trying to get into a pipe. Now, I'm pretty sure it actually did lead somewhere, but I was totally missing, like, the very center of the freaking thing. Or if you're totally not at the... I hate these Mario World pipes sometimes. You have to be at the right freaking center of them in order to get in, and it takes like 5 tries for me to get in, as you might have seen there. Okay, so obviously the key is up there. Now, I have watched someone else go through this much, much more easily than I did. I really don't know how. But I just really sucked here. This was just really sucky for me, and it really shouldn't have been, because I am better at Mario than this. I swear. I blame Maple Story. I keep on failing, and failing, and failing. And failing. And my computer went nuts there for a second. With these 2 bits in the video. Okay, so I made it that far, and obviously didn't put the save state right there, go figure. You might have noticed by now, I'm particularly bad. I was particularly bad with save states, because, well, let's see here. I've never really used them all that much, growing up. In fact, I've actually heard that this hack is actually supposed to be... It was intended to be run save stateless. With the exception of the long, long level with the Boomerang Brothers so far, I would have to agree with that. Seeing as this is the Star World, it would have to be a little bit trickier like this one is. Like this level. Okay, now, this is where the level kind of falls apart here. I'm supposed to be carrying this key, and what happens when Mario or Luigi starts wading into water with an object in their hands? They start flying 70 miles an hour in either direction. You're forced to tap back and forth to slow them down, because, good lord, those are some very thin vertical water bits. This, trying to get the key to the end of the level was a thorn in my side. To me, this was unnecessarily hard. It's not a bad idea or anything when you're not holding an object, in my opinion, but now that I've got to carry this key through there, I still have no idea how I managed to get this thing to the freaking hole in time. Dodging all these fireballs and then watch as they jump straight into my backside when I'm not looking. Constantly ramming my head in the ceiling, trying to get through all these other really thin vertical water bits. This is just madness. You can see this for yourself. This bit was particularly tricky. I mean, no, this is not Kaizo level by any degree, but this was actually kind of funny to me in a way. I'm actually a little more patient with games than I am with people. And so anytime I find myself in a frustrating spot, I actually sit and laugh. I don't ever seriously get frustrated with a game unless I've been doing it like 50 times. But anyway, yeah, see, I finally got to that keyhole, and I only had 16 Mario units of time left. And of course, it just leads to darkness. So of course, I must leave the darkness. Or leave Starland. Because there are more adventures to be had elsewhere. I have actually played a good number of those extra star levels, so not a lot of them will be a surprise when I do this thing again. I apologize for that in advance. But I will not spoil anything until the actual video, so there you go. And they are very entertaining levels in themselves. Now back to this kitty music that I really don't know what it is. I don't even know if it's kitty music, period, but it just kind of sounds like it. I mentioned that in an earlier video, so I won't get into that. I really don't know how that urchin managed to fit its fat rear through that space, but whatever. Reset door for the reasons of that P-switch, which I used the first time to find the secret exit alongside that key. For some reason, my computer is spazzing out trying to play this video. So I might have to screw around with my audio to make sure that it's right. Oh, lovely. You know, now that I think about it, that whistling chuck has only ever been used in one original Mario level ever. That was the, I do believe, the woods water level that was the only place they used it. And at that point, there were like 50 Rip Van Fish there. And they all woke up the instant he started whistling, which was the intended purpose of the whistling chuck, I guess. Very odd that he wasn't used elsewhere. Mickey Mouse, why do you hate the Mario Brothers so? Must you throw Torpedo Ted their way and give them harm? Totally Mickey Mouse, too. Black arm with a white glove. It's unmistakable. One could argue that it's also Minnie Mouse, but I kind of doubt that. Anyway, that will do it for these videos that I've not been doing live. So, see you next time, when I finally do it live.